In today's video, I am going to explain anatomy of muscles that attach to tibia. You are looking knee joint from medial view. This is inside part of knee. This is tibia. Okay, let's get start from this muscle. This is semimembranosus. Semimembranosus. This is part of hamstrings, right? Then let me focus on three muscles. This one is sartorius. Sartorius. This one is gracilis. Gracilis. Then last one is this one. Let me change color. This is it. This is semitendinosus. Semitendinosus. This is also part of hamstrings. Semimembranosus and semitendinosus are part of hamstrings. They are on medial part. Okay? Then, by the way, sartorius, gracilis, and semitendinosus attaches to same place on tibia. It is about this place. This area is called pes anserinus. Pes anserinus, that means goose foot. Goose foot. Pes anserinus, sartorius, gracilis, and semitendinosus attaches to pes anserinus. This is how you remember. Sartorius, gracilis, and semitendinosus. That's like a shiny green tomato. Okay, sartorius, gracilis, semitendinosus. Shiny green tomato. This is English version of how you remember. So let me know if you know how to remember in your language. Shiny green tomato. Then this is semimembranosus. Let me explain two more muscles. Next one is this one. This is popliteus. Popliteus. This is very deep muscle. This is so deep muscle. By the way, you do not see gastrocnemius. That's calf muscle. Gastrocnemius is removed, then popliteus shows up. This is so important for knee stability. Very important muscle. Then, last one from this picture is this one. This is part of calf muscle. This is soleus. Soleus. This is deep to gastrocnemius. Imagine gastrocnemius is like this. Then deep to this muscle, there is soleus. Can you imagine this visualization? Soleus is part of calf muscle. Then also deep to gastrocnemius, there is popliteus. Oh my god, so many muscles attached to superior part of tibia. Now let's go to deep posterior part of tibia. This is posterior view of lower leg. This part fibula. This part is tibia. Let me focus on two muscles. First muscle is this guy. This is tibialis posterior. Tibialis posterior. As I said, gastrocnemius is removed and soleus is removed. Thus, tibialis posterior is very deep muscle. By the way, if there is posterior, there should be anterior. Yes, indeed, there is tibialis anterior. Let me explain that muscle later. This is tibialis posterior. How about this one? This is flexor digitorum longus. Flexor digitorum longus. There's flexor digitorum longus, and there should be flexor hallucis longus. But flexor hallucis longus attaches to fibula. Okay, these three muscles are very deep lower leg muscles and ankle muscles. Anyway, two deep muscles attach to tibia. Tibialis posterior and flexor digitorum longus. Let me go to anterior part. This is anterior view. This is tibia. This is fibula. I said there's tibialis posterior. There should be tibialis anterior. This is tibialis anterior. Tibialis anterior. This is so strong ankle muscle. Tibialis anterior can do dorsiflexion. Very strong dorsiflexion muscle. And what is this one? This is extensor digitorum longus. We just looked flexor digitorum longus, right? This is flexor digitorum longus. And now, this is extensor digitorum longus. I know memorizing anatomy is so hard at first time, but this is just repeating. Repetitive thing. So please don't give up. Anatomy is fun stuff. Anyway, this is anterior part. This is tibialis anterior. This is extensor digitorum longus. Now at last, let me explain one fascia that is related to tibia. That's this one. By the way, this is lateral view. This is fibula. This is tibia. What is this connective tissue? This is iliotibial band. Iliotibial band, also known as ITB. Iliotibial band is part of thigh fascia. Imagine whole fascia is surrounding thigh. Iliotibial band is the thickest part of thigh fascia. And iliotibial band attaches to tibia. If you use thigh muscles repetitively, chronically, your iliotibial band gets tight. Now what's gonna happen? There's chance that you have pain around lateral part of knee joint, lateral part of tibia. This symptom is very common among endurance athletes, such as long distance runners, such as a football player, such as basketball players, you know, the people who run a lot. Their iliotibial band may be very tight, very stiff. Anyway, I explained anatomy of muscles that attach to tibia. I explained medial view first, that's shiny green tomato, right? Sartorius, gracilis, semitendinosus, semimembranosus, and the deep muscle, popliteus, and soleus. Posterior view, tibialis posterior, flexor digitorum longus. How about anterior view? Tibialis anterior, extensor digitorum longus, and at last part, I explained one fascia. That's iliotibial band. Memorizing anatomy terminology is very difficult at first time, but this is fundamental. Fundamental is key for studying. I hope this video helps your understanding of anatomy. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.